Scripture reading this morning is Psalm 116, 1-2. I love the Lord, for he heard my voice. He heard my cry for mercy. Because he turned his ear to me, I will call upon him as long as I live. And verses 12-19. How can I repay the Lord for all his goodness to me? I will lift up the cup of salvation and call on the name of the Lord. I will fulfill my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. O Lord, truly I am your servant. I am your servant, the son of your maidservant. You have freed me from my chains. I will sacrifice a thank offering to you and call on the name of the Lord. I will fulfill my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people, in the courts of the house of the Lord, in the midst, O Jerusalem. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for your presence here with us today. We thank you, O God, for the sharing of so many blessings of the meeting of old friends, and just the time being able to spend together, Lord. We thank you for each and every blessing, Lord, when we see you in nature, and we thank you for each gift that we see. Lord, this day we lift up the prayers for Ed Montgomery having another cornea transplant on Thursday. We pray, O God, that this is successful, that he has complete healing, and that this will be the last time he has to endure this. We pray continued prayers for Dave Zaremba, not only for pancreatitis and gallstones, but has gallstones as well. He's home, but uncomfortable and on meds. So Lord, we pray for his continued healing as well. Healing for Sylvia
Rouser.
Lord, you know what is going on, and we pray, oh God, that you would speak into her life and provide the healing that is needed. We pray for Gordon's cousin, Jerry, in the hospital, awaiting biopsy results for the tumor on the bladder. Lord, many others need your healing touch. There are so many that continue to be missing from our midst this day. Let us remember Claire Hanaway and her family, and Al and Pat Seaman in their absence as well. Provide the healing and comfort and support that each of them need for their individual cases. Lord, may your spirit dwell in their homes, Lord, to give them hope and faith for each new day. And we pray, O God, for Nicole graduating from Steinert on Wednesday. And we pray, O God, for all the graduates. Lord, we know that it is a delicate time and so many things can go wrong. So Lord, we just pray that you would provide them with safety as they celebrate. Lord, give them a bit of wisdom that they need as they gather with friends and travel on our roads, Lord. We know, God, that they are entering a new phase in their life and they need all the wisdom, Lord, that they can get. So, Lord, bless them and keep them safe. Also, bless their families, Lord, as they see this as a time of transition as well. For many will be leaving home for the first time, Lord. So comfort their families as well and give them all that's needed so that their children can grow and that they can flourish away from home. And Lord, we thank you that we can gather in this place. We thank you for the men that came out yesterday and enjoyed their time together, Lord. So important that men can gather and share whatever it is they shared around the tables, Lord, because Marie and I didn't listen. So Lord, we just thank you that they were given a safe place as well and a time for fellowship. Lord, and I thank you most for Marie and all the help that she gives in the preparation of the breakfast, Lord. She does most of the work. So, Lord, we just thank you. I thank you for her presence in my life and in the ministry of this church as well. Now, God, we pray that you would continue to open your word to us this day. Lord, lead us as we look to your word in worship. For we pray all of this in your son's most precious name. Amen. Amen. Now you can sit. Now this morning, I'm going to ask Octavia to help me with the sermon. So come on up, Octavia. Now what she's going to do is she's going to take, come on up. I know you like it up here. She's going to take the microphone and I'm going to ask some questions. Now, what I want you to do is, if you have an answer that you want to share, raise your hand. She's going to give you the microphone. You listening? You're going to give them the microphone, and they're going to share the answer, and then you take the microphone back. Okay? There you go. Now, the first question is, what advice did your father give you? Anybody? Okay, go see Mr. Barry over there. Give him the microphone.
I've been asked this question several times, and most recently this past week. My father always told me, at the end of the day, look in the mirror.
Ooh. That's good. Anybody else? Raise your hand.
My father always said moderation in all things.
Moderation in all things. Okay, go all the way in the back to Miss Edna first. All the way.
My father told me never to sass my mother. You only had one mother.
Never sass your mother. You only have one mother. Ooh, that's a good one. Okay, Joe?
My father said, since he always had to work all the time, listen to your mother.
Anybody else? Okay. Give it to Mommy.
Okay, my stepfather always used to tell me, it's just money. They print more every day. No sense in worrying about it.
Don't worry about money. Like that one.
My father never said this, but he always showed me. Go to church every Sunday.
Go to church.
Yeah. Oh, man, Kathy. You go.
Getting your exercise today.
Well, I was going to say the same thing as so. But he also showed us how to enjoy life.
Enjoy life.
Be kind. And always, always have a smile on your face.
Amen. Amen. Lots of good advice. Now, for the fathers, what advice did you or do you give your children? Fathers out there, what advice did you or do you give to your children? Go see Dad. Uh-oh.
Don't be afraid to try new things.
Don't be afraid
especially
to try
food.
New things.
Good luck.
Be smart.
Any other fathers? What advice did you give to your children?
They don't listen anyhow.
Yeah. Okay. Well, go see Miss Ruth. Raise your hand.
Not my father, but my husband always used to say, don't worry about something that you can't do anything about.
That's a good one.
Yeah.
Other fathers, anything? Okay, give Mr. Harry.
I always told my children, no matter where you go or what you do, just know that I love you.
Amen. Very nice, very nice. Fathers, you're not a father, but we'll let you go. Okay.
I'm speaking for the father next to me. Always do your best and emulate the man that's in front of you, and they have a wonderful model to follow.
Okay. Okay, now, for everybody, What word or phrase describes your father? You want to pick one word or one phrase. What describes your father? Anybody brave enough to share? Go see Miss Marie.
It was my, my babysitter's husband, which is, I consider my stepfather. He was amazing.
Amazing. That's a good characteristic. Anybody else?
Stubborn.
Stubborn.
Contented.
Contented. Well, that's a good one.
Jolly.
Jolly. Mm-hmm. I'm sure everybody didn't have these characteristics with their fathers. Okay, go up. Go back to see Mr. Barry over here. Okay.
Taking a shortcut.
I guess you're getting tired.
Loving.
Loving.
Caring.
Caring. Okay.
Faithful.
Faithful. Okay, Octavia, now all the way to the back to Miss Jill. Jill, keep your hand up so she can see you.
Hey, Octavia.
Yeah.
He could fix anything.
Yeah, Mr. Fix-It.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yep.
Okay, over here to Miss Bonnie.
Tough love.
Tough love. Okay, one more. We've come down front. Raise your hand, Alma, so she can see you. Right here.
Compassionate.
Compassionate. A lot of nice characteristics. You know, this was one of the DJs on K-Love was doing this all week. And I thought if I could pick one word, it would be grumpy. Anybody else have a grumpy father? I'm sure there was more. You have a grumpy father? Okay, yeah. Mine's always grumpy. Yeah.
He was always grumpy and grouchy.
Yep. I relate to that. Okay, last question. What did your father teach you?
Even though my mother took me driving at her stick shift, it was my father who told me how to figure out the clutch and the brake and the gas pedal.
Octavia?
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 Yeah, back here. Give
right
it to
here.
Mr. Gordon.
My father taught me not to put nails into outlets.
My stepfather taught me to be kind to everyone, even a stranger, because you never know what someone is going through, so you should always be kind.
Always be kind. Like that one.
My father taught me how to work hard. My grandfather taught me how to find the balance between work and family.
Oh, amen.
Wow. Nice.
Anybody else? Oh.
Well, wrong one.
Good honor on a My dad taught me a lot of things, but one of the fun things was never turn your back on the ocean.
That saved you, didn't it?
Yep, many times.
Okay, Mr. Tom over here.
He taught me to be a Christian.
There you go. Important lesson. Okay, Octavia, up here. Now, what did your father teach you? Dad, have you been slacking off? What did Daddy teach you? Did he teach you how to take care of the cats?
Kind of,
uh-oh. How about the chickens? Did Daddy teach you about the chickens?
Yeah.
Okay, we got the chicken keeper going. Anything else he taught you? How about clean up your room?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Still working on it.
And he said, try new things. Are you trying new things? Mm. You can be honest.
No.
Well, thanks for helping out today. You can go sit down now. I'm sure you're out of breath. Now that you heard how our earthly fathers have impacted our lives, let's look to today's gospel lesson to see how Jesus instructed the disciples. From Matthew 9:35, beginning with 35, into 10:8. Jesus went through all the towns and villages, teaching in their synagogues, proclaiming the good news of the kingdom, and healing every disease and sickness. When he saw the crowds, he had compassion on them because they were harassed and helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, "The harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. Ask the Lord of the harvest, therefore, to send out workers into his harvest field." Jesus called his 12 disciples to him and gave them authority to drive out impure spirits and to heal every disease and sickness. These are the names of the 12 apostles. First, Simon, who is called Peter, and his brother Andrew, James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John, Philip and Bartholomew, Thomas and Matthew, the tax collector, James, son of Alphaeus, and Thaddeus, Simon the Zealot, and Judas Iscariot, who betrayed him. These 12 Jesus sent out with the following instructions. Do not go among the Gentiles or enter any town of the Samaritans. Go rather to the lost sheep of Israel. As you go, proclaim the message. The kingdom of heaven has come near. Heal the sick, raise the dead, cleanse those who have leprosy, drive out demons. Freely you have received, freely give. May these words inspire us today to be more like Jesus. Jesus carefully picked his disciples, and as we know, they were all kinds of men, different yet the same. Mostly fishermen, yet a tax collector, and also one who would later betray him. Perhaps the reason they were chosen was that we would have examples to follow, for they were imperfect men, just as we are imperfect. Yet they were singled out to hold a special place in Jesus' ministry. One characteristic that they all possessed was the ability to listen to Jesus' direction. They listened, and then they were obedient to follow those directions. Being today's Father's Day, another Hallmark holiday where cards and gifts take center stage, I want to talk about the directions that fathers provide. Let's begin by saying no father could ever measure up to God. So let's show a bit of grace to those earthly fathers who tried their best, yet fell short of perfection. You see, God had a perfect son, Jesus. God gave direction, and Jesus was obedient even till his death on the cross. So men, don't worry. Jesus paid the price already, and hopefully none of you will face such serious commands. We know that Jesus was perfect. Yet we also know that as he walked the earth, he was fully human and fully God. He displayed every emotion known to man. Sorrow, grief, frustration, joy. We have to surmise that not only did he weep, but he laughed as well. For that is all part of being fully human. But Jesus struggled when his disciples couldn't understand his direction. When he taught them lesson after lesson, and yet they still didn't understand. So fathers, if you haven't experienced it, you will, with your children or your grandchildren. They will not always learn the lessons you want them to learn the first time around. Remember, we are all human. Just think about your own father and the things he tried to teach you. Did you get it the first time? Or were there repeated lessons? I think that Jesus' earthly father probably experienced the same thing, as Joseph was a carpenter and he taught Jesus his trade as well. I am sure it took more than just one lesson to become a skilled carpenter. I am reminded of a friend who races cars. He constantly posts on Facebook all of his racing adventures. And there is not one picture or one story that doesn't involve his son and now his grandson, as he teaches them all about building and rebuilding and maintaining a race car. Not all successes, yet each a learning experience that they take to the next race. So as Jesus gave direction to his disciples, this day I want all you fathers to realize the great task you have as well. You will always be role models to your children and your grandchildren. They are watching and sometimes listening, but just know that they are sponges, and one day they will tell you exactly what you taught them. One of the questions I ask when preparing for a funeral is what lessons that loved one taught you. Sometimes I get great answers, and sometimes I get answers that cannot be repeated. So today, make sure your children will be able to share what you have given them. Let those lessons be lessons of goodness, of faith, of triumph, and also how to handle life's tough times. Let the grace that God has given you resonate in your children's life as well. May today be a great day, a day of remembering those who spoke into your life, a day when your children let you know how you have spoken into their life, and may today be a day of unending grace for you, your children, and your grandchildren. All of your families are a gift from our Heavenly Father. Make sure you listen to God's directions for your life. Amen, and happy Father's Day.
Amen.
Let's look to 440. On this day, let us remember that God has given us all that we need to survive. That God has blessed us with numerous blessings, even when we don't realize it or recognize them. May you go forth from this day recognizing God's touch in your life through loved ones, through relatives, and through all that you come in contact with. For God is that good Father to all of us. Amen.